This video will explain how to connect a modem to a computer that does not feature any serial ports using a MOXA module. We have already explained how to do it using a serial to USB converter in a previous video. MOXA modules are serial to Ethernet converters which let you create virtual RS-232 ports on your machine, creating a link with whatever you plug into your MOXA module. This device lets you connect serial devices to computers which do not feature serial ports. It is a good option for virtual machines, but you can also use these modules if, for whatever reason, a direct cable connection is inconvenient. A variety of modules are available allowing for one or more simultaneous connection per device. Here are a module featuring four serial ports and another featuring only one. We will use the latter for this tutorial. Let's see what's in the box. You will find your new MOXA module alongside a CD containing all the necessary drivers and configuration software, as well as a power supply. The first thing to do is to connect the module to your local network and power it up. Then we must install the driver for this module, which can be found on the CD provided by the manufacturer. The driver can also be found on your Micromedia installation USB drive or DVD. Browse the installation CD and find the setup for Nport Administrator in Software, Windows, Nport Administration Suite. Launch the setup. Please note that this requires elevated privileges. Use default parameters. The installation should now be complete and Nport automatically started. The first thing to do is to find your MOXA device on the network. As you can see, the device was automatically detected alongside its default IP address. We must first unlock the device. If the password has not been changed, it should be MOXA. Now that this has been done, we can set up our modem. You can change the IP address of the device by double-clicking it. Under the Network tab, we can specify the IP address we wish to assign to the modem. In our case, we configure our modem to use DHCP. We then can save the changes we made. A new scan allows us to check that the IP has indeed been changed. Let us add the virtual COM port to Windows. Go to COM Mapping and click Add. The device we have just configured is automatically selected. We only need to click OK. The MOXA we have added is now linked to our new virtual COM port, COM4 in our example. All we have left to do is to save the changes we have made by clicking Apply, and then Yes. This warning asks us to check the mode used by the modem, which we will do. Open back up the module's properties window. Under operating mode, check that Real COM mode has been selected. Now that the modem has been set up, we can close Nport. If necessary, you can access Nport at any time from the Start menu, provided you have elevated privileges. Additional modules can be added and existing ones deleted.